Hey guys, Irene here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I have a Photoshop tutorial for you guys. I'm gonna show you how I easily transformed the greens in the image. I have been posting a lot of images with lots of different variations of green, and a lot of you guys have been asking me how do I do that. So that's what I'm gonna show you guys today. Just a little update on my workshop in London, UK. It's already halfway filled out. There's only 2 spots left in the weekend workshop. So if you were curious about that, I want to suggest you guys hurry up. I will leave the link in the description of this video to all of the information about this upcoming workshop and how you guys can sign up. And yeah, let's go straight to the video. We're going to be mostly using Camera Raw today. I have been using it a ton lately. I think it's just super powerful and very, very easy to use. Before I do anything though, I want to go ahead and duplicate my layer. So I'm going to right click on the background, duplicate the layer and press OK. This ensures that if I did anything wrong, I can always go back to the original image. And also with the duplicate layer, I can mask my model out and affect only the background. So I'm gonna go ahead into filter and press Camera Raw Filter. If you have a very old version of Photoshop, you might not have this available in your filter. But if you have the newest version of Photoshop, you should have no problem here. By the way, this image is straight out of camera. I didn't really do any kind of adjustments to it, and I'm gonna go straight into calibration. This is one of the best and easiest way to affect your greens in the image. It is so easy, you guys. So let's do the first one. One of my favorite things to do to the green, and we're gonna start with the green primary. I'm gonna pull it to this side, which as you can see makes the greens have a lot more of the blue in them. And that's what this green primary can do here. If you bring it to the left side, the greens will have a lot more yellow. If you bring to the left side, the greens will have a lot more blue. If you go all the way, you can see it gives you that very trendy color that everyone is doing right now, where you have the red and the green. And the reason why this combination works so well is because red and green are on the opposite sides of the color wheel. Everything is on the opposite sides, like the yellow and blue, green and red are the complementary colors, and they're gonna look really, really nicely together. Now, I personally am not a huge, huge fan of this trend just because I like to keep my images looking a little bit more natural, but I like to implement some of these trends into my images. So instead of going all the way on the green primary, I'm gonna just go a little bit there. So it still gives us that kind of bluish hue to it without kind of over exaggerating it. Now on the red primary, I'm gonna go actually this way and I'm gonna saturate the reds a little bit more. So that looks really good to me, and that's all I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna press OK. So here is the before and after on that. As you can see, we are already getting so much more of that green and red, and I think it looks really, really beautiful together. Now I'm gonna play a little bit with selective color to kind of finesse the colors even more. So I'm gonna press the adjustment layer here and choose selective color. Now when you do that, a few things you got to make sure you have on. First of all, make sure it's on absolute, not on relative. Second of all, make sure that your layer is about 2 of your layers. If it's in the middle like this, then it's going to be only affecting the background layer, which is our original layer. If it's on top of all of the layers, it's going to be affecting this one as well, and this is what we want. So now I'm gonna go ahead and choose greens. I'm gonna make the greens even more green over here, and I'm also gonna make them a little bit more bluish. So right this way. Now I'm gonna choose yellows, and I'm gonna bring them back just a little bit because I feel like her skin tone looks just a little bit bleak. So I'm gonna bring the yellows, and I don't know if you guys noticed, but it also brings a little bit of the yellow in the green, making it not as blue anymore, but still making it super, super vibrant and green. I'm gonna go into the reds and I'm gonna darken them just a little bit. I'm gonna bring them to the red side just a little bit and to the yellow side as well. Another thing that I love to do is go to blacks, and here we can inject just a little bit of color into the black. So I can give it a little bit of the blue or a little bit of the yellow. I like to give it just a tiny bit of that blue color and maybe go a little bit more with the yellow. Okay, that looks amazing. I'm gonna go now into whites, and this another little trick of mine that I like to do to almost all of my images. I add a little bit of color into the highlights. So here we can add a little bit of yellow or a little bit of blue. I think a little bit of yellow looks very, very nice. Now, I know that this tutorial is all about the greens, but you guys have to understand that we cannot only affect the greens and leave all of the other colors in the image the way they are. I always make sure that all of the other colors in the image contrast and cooperate nicely with the main colors. So the main color is green, and then we're making sure that all the other colors work with that main green color. So here's the before and after. This is the effect that I use on almost all of my newest pictures. You will recognize this on my Instagram. I think it looks so, so vibrant and beautiful, and I absolutely love it. Alright, now let's do a little bit of a different effect, but using the same techniques. I'm gonna duplicate the layer first, go into filter, camera, raw filter, and again, I'm gonna go into the calibration. Now, again, I'm gonna start with bringing the green primary here, but now we're also gonna use the blue primary. So I'm gonna bring it this way. And as you can see, what it does to the greenery, it brings out some of the yellow and the reds through the green really, really nicely. You can also just leave your greens the way they are if you like more of that yellow color, but I personally really love when there's a nice contrast between a more blue green and a more yellow green. So we're trying to make the leaves have that kind of double color to them, with the leaves here being quite yellow and orange, and then some of them being quite dark and green. And again, I think it creates a really, really nice effect. We can also go ahead and bring the red primary this way. Alright, that looks good. Now I'm gonna go into hue saturation, and I'm gonna make the greens more green here, and then I'm gonna saturate the yellows, the oranges, the reds, and I'm gonna also make all those three a little bit brighter. So brighter here, brighter here, brighter here. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. I think I want to bring this even more this way. Okay, I think that looks really awesome. Maybe I'm gonna give it a little bit more vibrance and exposure. So as you can see, the model herself is not looking that great, although I really, really love the way the background looks. But don't worry, we can easily fix that. So I'm gonna press OK. And because we did this on a background layer, we still have the original image underneath. So what we can do is we can take an eraser tool, and we can easily erase whatever we just did off of the model. So that's what I'm gonna be doing. I'm gonna erase slowly only just the model and leave the background the way it is. That way we get that beautiful background that we created, but her skin tone is not gonna look very orange and terrible. All right, so here it is, the before and after. Now, if you wanna go even further, which I usually do, you can go into selective color again. So I'm gonna go into adjustment layers, choose the selective color, and then you see, gotta make sure that the selective color is on top of the layers. Now I'm gonna again choose the green. I'm gonna make it a little bit more green. I'm gonna make it maybe a little bit brighter and more green again. Now I'm gonna choose the yellows. I'm gonna make them more yellow. And same for the reds. Maybe give them a little bit of the color. Okay. That looks great. So this is before and after of a little bit of the selective color. Now again, if you didn't like what it did to the model herself, you can always just grab that eraser tool again and erase that off of the model so that it affects only the background. Now, you have to remember that you cannot erase things if you don't have a duplicate layer. So always make sure you create duplicate layers. All right, so this is our second effect. And let me show you the before and after. So before and after. What if we want to change the seasons and actually make it look as if it's fall and all of the leaves are yellow and orange? Well, it's quite simple with Camera Raw as well. So the same thing, I'm going to duplicate the layer. I'm going to go into Filter and Camera Raw Filter and going to go to Calibration. So I'm going to bring the blue primary all the way here and I'm going to do the same with the green primary. Now you can go ahead and leave just a little bit of green in there if you would like to, or you can go all the way down and make everything very orange. You can also play around with the red primary. Again, you can give it a little bit more of a green color or very orange color. Let's go to the very orange color, and you can also go into the hue saturation adjustments again, and maybe let's go into the luminance. I'm gonna make the oranges just a little bit darker and yellows a little bit brighter, just to give it a little bit more of a dimension. So I'm gonna press OK, and it looks pretty good. And now I'm just gonna go ahead and mask out the model. So with my eraser brush, I'm just gonna quickly erase some of this off of the model, and mostly erasing it off of her skin. Now, whenever I'm erasing something like this, I always use a soft rounded brush so that I won't get any of the harsh edges. All right, so this is it. This is before and after. As you can see, it is super easy to change the green into whatever color you would like. So let's follow this kind of fantasy theme and play around with some more unnatural colors. So I'm gonna duplicate the layer, press OK. I'm gonna go to Filter, Camera Raw, Calibration. I hope you guys have remembered this by now. And the green primary, I'm gonna go here. And in the red primary, I'm gonna go over here to give it a little bit more of that orangey color. Then I'm gonna go to the hue saturation and I'm gonna make the greens a lot more saturated. Now here's another tip for you guys. It is a lot easier to change colors that are very saturated than the ones that are more toned down. So before you want to switch the color to a dramatically different color, it is better to saturate that color a little bit more. It's just gonna be easier for Photoshop to kind of find it and change it. So I'm going to press OK. Now I'm going to go into adjustment layers and selective color. Make sure that again that it's at the very top. I'm going to select green and now I'm going to bring it all the way to the yellow side here on the left, and then all the way to the right side on the green. Now it's already changed to quite a dark green bluish kind of turquoise color, but it needs to be even further than that. So I'm gonna do another selective color and I'm gonna do the greens again and make them here again. And as you can see, it changed the greens now to a very kind of cyan color. So now I can take the cyans and bring them even more over here to give them kind of a blue tint. That looks pretty cool. Now I can go into blacks and give it a little bit of even more of a blue tint. Now to offset all of this blue color, I can go into yellow and make it a little bit more yellow, give it a little bit of the orangey color, and then go into reds. We're gonna make them darker and more red, like this. I can also go into the whites and kind of play around with colors here. I think I'm gonna give it a little bit of a blue tint. So that looks cool. Again, this is a very interesting kind of edit. We completely changed the color of the greens. This is not for everyone. This looks quite unnatural, but it looks quite cool as well. So sometimes I like to experiment with different colors and make these kind of edits. So before and after, as you can see, we completely changed the color of the image. And this is why I love Photoshop so much. It just gives you so much creativity, so many ways to go with the colors. You can completely change the whole tone, the whole story of the image with just Photoshop. So this is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a like and comment down below. Your comments and likes really, really help my channel. So go ahead and do that. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. And I'll see you guys in my new video. Bye!